The sixth principle of universal design is low physical effort. This principle is achieved when the design can be used efficiently and comfortably and with a minimum of fatigue. The design should be effective and easy to use for users with differing physical abilities. The low physical effort principle has four guidelines. The first guideline is, allow user to maintain a neutral body position. Danny Housley explains how a sit-to-stand desk and an adjustable computer monitor can be utilized to ensure that he is in the proper position to access his workstation.
Three other levels programmed into this desk. I have one that's very low. I have a small stool under my desk that sometimes I sit on, and I want the desk to be a little bit lower for that. And then I just have the regular sitting position as well. But this is going to be good for somebody who maybe small of stature. They can lower the desk to be in a comfortable working position. Or somebody who's a wheelchair user, they can raise it up to comfortably pull underneath it.
The next guideline for low physical effort is use reasonable operating forces. This principle includes designs that require minimal movements to use the product. Examples can include a storage container that can be easily opened with little force, or a building entrance that doesn't require the use of a hand. The third guideline of low physical effort is minimize repetitive actions. Liz Persaud explains how using her voice to input text minimizes the need for the repetitive action of typing and allows her to reduce fatigue.
I have difficulty writing. I lose energy very quickly. Sometimes a pen or pencil feels like it weighs 600 pounds, but I have the ability to speak. I have the ability to hit switches and to use other modes of input. For example, I use my voice for everything. I control my environment. I send emails out. I write documents and reports.
The last guideline for the universal design principle, low physical effort, is minimize sustained physical effort. John Sanford, an industrial design professor at Georgia Tech, explains how developing a one-handed corkscrew can reduce sustained physical effort.
Developing a one-handed wine opener, corkscrew. And the idea there is that it requires a lot of effort and sustained effort to hold a bottle and also hold a corkscrew. And so we started looking at electronic corkscrews, right? But you still have to hold the bottle and you still have to hold the corkscrew. So the idea is to develop a one-handed corkscrew. It basically holds the bottle in place and it'll remove it. So there's no effort whatsoever other than putting the corkscrew on and turning it on.
This principle goes beyond just ease of use, and it minimizes the strength required, the sustained forces needed, and any repetitive actions that are necessary. Low physical effort ensures that a product or interface will be usable by all individuals, regardless of their strength or stamina. This video was produced for the Rehabilitation Engineering Research Center on Technologies to Support Aging in Place for People with Long-Term Disabilities, RERC TechSage, and the Disability Rehabilitation Research Project on Universal Design Practices to Enhance Work Outcomes by the Center for Inclusive Design and Innovation, Georgia Institute of Technology, and Tools for Life, Georgia's Assistive Technology Act program. RERC TechSage and are supported by grants 90REGE006 and 90DP0049 from the National Institute on Disability, Independent Living, and Rehabilitation Research, NIDLR. NIDLR is the center within the Administration for Community Living, ACL, Department of Health and Human Services, HHS. The contents of this video do not necessarily represent the policies of NIDLR, ACL, or HHS, and you should not assume endorsement by the federal government.